Heterochromia can be one of those beautiful, stunning genetic mutations of the eye that causes one eye to be a different color than the other one. In this video, we're going to go over the details of heterochromia, and if this is something that you've acquired later in life, you have one eye that has turned a different color, you definitely want to watch this video because it could be something concerning. Let's focus in. Hey, howdy everybody, this is Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy, and I do videos all about the eyes to help you with your eyes. If this is something you're interested in, make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell to make sure you don't miss any of my future videos. Now let's focus on heterochromia. The first type of heterochromia is called complete heterochromia or heterochromia iridum, where you have a completely different color on one eye than the other one. Another type of heterochromia is called partial heterochromia, segmental or sectoral heterochromia, but also known as heterochromia iridis. And that's where you maybe have brown eyes, but maybe on one eye there's a little section or a little wedge that is a different color. Maybe it's blue or green. And then there's something called central heterochromia, where maybe the central ring of the iris is a different color, and the further out to the periphery it goes, it morphs into a different color of iris as well. Now, most of the time when you see a heterochromia, it's a congenital condition, meaning that person was likely born with it or developed it really soon right after birth. And this is actually a rare condition. Only about 200,000 people in America actually have this condition. That's 6 in 10,000 people. And so the population in the world, less than 1% of the people have heterochromia. Now, this genetic condition actually affects the melanin that's in the iris. That's what gives the eye its color. So you'll have one eye that might have less melanin or less pigment in that eye compared to the other eye. A congenital heterochromia is actually pretty exciting to see as a doctor. Because it's so rare, it's pretty fun to actually see patients that have this groovy genetic mutation. Now, usually when people are born with heterochromia, it doesn't mean that they have any other health problems or eye problems. It's not a symptom of a condition, it's just a genetic mutation. Now, that being said, there are certain conditions that also can have the symptom of heterochromia, and there are a bunch of conditions. I'll kind of list them on the screen here so you can kind of pause the screen and go over those. But yeah, there's definitely possibilities where you can have a heterochromia that might be linked or might be a symptom of something else going on. There's actually a few famous celebrities that have a heterochromia. Superman, Henry Cavill, actually has a partial or sectoral heterochromia in one of his eyes. Kate Bosworth. A lot of people think that David Bowie has a heterochromia, but his is something different. He actually had an injury in one of his eyes that caused his pupil to dilate, and so his pupil makes his eye look darker than his other bright blue eye. So it's actually something completely different. Now, if you've developed a heterochromia or a different eye color compared to the other eye, that's where it can be concerning because it could be a sign of some other eye condition or health problem going on. And the list of possible conditions that are linked to heterochromia later in life is pretty extensive as well. I'll put the list on the screen so you can look over those, but it can be linked to eye injury, eye surgery, bleeding in the eye, eye swelling like uveitis, iritis. It can be linked to something called Fuchs heterochromic cyclitis, which is also a big one. Certain glaucoma medications can change the eye color. Latisse, which is a glaucoma medication that's been adapted to eyelash growth, that can also darken your eye color. If you have bright blue eyes, you might not want to use Latisse. Now, if you have developed a heterochromia later in life, you definitely want to go in and get an eye exam, a full comprehensive eye exam to check the health of the eyes. Because mainly the treatment for heterochromia is to treat the underlying condition, treat what has caused the heterochromia. And the heterochromia can be a blaring symptom, a blaring sign that something else is going on. If you happen to be one of those rare people, less than 1% of the population that actually has a heterochromia, please comment below. I'm kind of curious to see how many people actually watch this that actually have a heterochromia. Hey, and thanks for watching that whole video. If you like this type of video, definitely hit that like button for me. I'm Dr. Neil Guyman, Dr. Eye Guy, focusing on you and your eyes. Stay focused and make sure you check out my other videos right there. And I'll see you in the next video.